It is day 5 of the World University Games here in Gwangju, Korea. They're a look at the Universiad Cauldron. We go back to last night to wrap up the individual apparatus finals in gymnastics. Also from day 4, rowing competition featuring the men's eights. And also swimming, with medals being handed out in multiple disciplines. From today, a classic basketball matchup. United States takes on Serbia. In archery, we have recurve finals. And also team and individual shooting competition. From last evening, the wrap-up to the artistic gymnastics competition here at Gwangju. Here you get a look at the Gwangju University Gymnasium. The individual apparatus finals, men's vault. This is Chen Yu of China. He was 6th in the individual all-around. This is his second attempt. Bit of a step back on the landing. He would score 15.433 on this second vault. That will give him an overall score of 15.383 to win him a gold medal. Igor Radivilov of Ukraine will win his third, having won a silver in rings and a bronze in team. And Oleg Vernayev wins bronze, his fifth medal of the games. Now the women's beam. There's Yu Minobe of Japan. She won a silver in the team competition earlier here at Universiad. Polina Fedorova of Russia, also in this competition. She won a gold in the team competition earlier on. And also Felipa Martins, who was 4th in the all-around, competing for Portugal. And there's the dismount for Minobe, a slight step, but a really solid performance for her. She'll score 14.0 as you get a replay of it here. And that score of 14, enough to give her a gold medal. Fedorova of Russia wins silver, and Martins of Portugal the bronze. Now the women's floor exercise. Here you see Polina Fedorova, who, as mentioned, just won that silver medal in the beam. Daria Lizarova of Russia, also competing here. She has a gold in the team competition as well as a bronze in the vault. Kelly Sim of Great Britain, the all-around champion, also won a silver in the vault competition, is in the floor exercise as well. Good performance for Fedorova. You get a look at one of her tumbling passes there. Score of 14.200 and a gold medal, her second of the games. Elizarova will win silver, while Kelly Sim will take her third medal, a bronze. Men's parallel bars. This is Oleg Vernayev. He is the current world champion and 2-time defending European champion on this apparatus. Already a winner of 5 medals here at Universia, and a perfect dismount there for Vernayev. Get a look at it here, sticks it. And the world champion will add to his medal total here in Gwangju, his 6th, 2 gold. 1 in the all-around, 1 here on the parallel bars. Komodo of Japan, the silver, and Yoshioka, also of Japan, the bronze. Last up, the men's horizontal bar. This is Fabian Hambuchen of Germany. He was 5th earlier on in the floor exercise. Trying to hold off Shogo Nonomura of Japan. He already won 4 medals. And there you see the dismount for Hambuchen. He loves it. And the German supporters love it too. Here, a good close-up of the intricate handwork that has to be done by these athletes. And there you see the solid dismount. And that's a gold medal performance for Fabian Hamboeken. Score of 15.266. Silver to Shogo Nonomura and a bronze to his Japanese teammate Yuya Kamoto. From yesterday at the Chengdu Tangium Lake rowing competition. Men's single sculls first up. There you see the start list. In lane three, a bronze medalist at the U23 Worlds last year in Rome. That's Zygmantas Galasanskis of Lithuania. There you see him pulling away from Simone Martini of Italy. Martini won a silver in the Coxless Fours in Kazan. And the Lithuanian at the end, just ahead of Martini to win the gold medal. In third, it is Keon Metzmakers of the Netherlands. And there you see the three medalists here in men's single sculls. Now it's the women's turn. And another Lithuanian in lane four. That's Lina Saltytė. She was fourth at the 2014 European Rowing Championships. This also features the gold medalist from Kazan's Universiade in 2013. That's in lane five, Natalia Dvgodko. But at the end, Saltytė easily wins this one. Second place going to Dvgodko. And in third, from the Netherlands, Marloes Oldenburg. And there you see Saltytė with her gold medal. And finally, the men's eights. There's the start list. Ukraine, the defending silver medalists, they're in lane four. And the Netherlands, the defending bronze medalists, both from Kazan in 2013. There you see the Americans well out in front of the Netherlands and Ukraine as they make their way towards the finish line. And there you see, crossing the finish line well in front, Ukraine will just edge out the Netherlands for silver. And in fourth place there are the Russians. And the Americans waving the stars and stripes, thrilled with that gold medal performance here in men's eights. As said, Ukraine takes silver and the Netherlands will win the bronze medal. Back to last night in swimming competition at the Nambu University Aquatic Center. We'll first look at the women's 100 meter backstroke. In lane five, Rachel Bootsma of the United States. She competed in this event at the London 2012 Olympics. Lane three, Elizabeth Pelton, also of the US. And in lane four, Kylie Mass of Canada. There you see Mass with the white cap right in the middle of your screen. And it'll be Mass just ahead right now of Pelton, trying to hold both the Americans off as they head to the wall. And it looks like Mass will do it. Kylie Mass of Canada, in a time of 59.97 seconds, will win the gold medal. Pelton will take the silver, and fellow American Rachel Bootsma will win the bronze medal. There you see the final times. And the three medalists from North America, they're on the podium. Next up, the men's 200 meter butterfly. A double medalist from Kazan in lane four. That's Evgeny Koptalov of Russia. He won a bronze in the 100 meter butterfly and also gold in the 4x100 meter medley. And also the bronze medalist from that 4x100 meter medley. That's Masayuki Umamoto of Japan. He is in lane five. But pulling away right now, there's Koptalov. He's trying to hold off Yuya Yajima there in lane two. And Koptalov will win another Universiade medal, this time a gold here in the men's 200 meter butterfly, and he is thrilled. In second, Yajima of Japan, and Umemoto of Japan as well will claim the bronze medal. And finally, here the 4x200 meter freestyle relay. This is the women. United States in lane four, the Universiad record holders from back in Shenzhen in 2011. This features Leah Smith, who already won gold earlier in the day in the 400 meter freestyle event. And also Shannon Vreeland, who is looking for her third gold medal of the games, having won in the 4x100 meter freestyle relay and the 100 meter freestyle event. And the Americans trying to get under Universiad record time, and they will do it, breaking their own record from Shenzhen, this time in a time of 7:53.88 seconds. China will win silver. Zhang Cixi wins her second gold, having won in the 200 meter individual medley. And Japan will win the bronze in a time of 8:1.18 seconds. And there are the Americans, Leah Smith, Haley Flickinger, Chelsea Chanot, and Shannon Vreeland, gold medalists here in the women's 4x200 meter freestyle relay. The Dongkang College Gymnasium, site of a huge basketball game today in Group D action. United States taking on Serbia, both teams 3-0 coming into this one. 8-8 here in the first quarter. Great little bounce pass there, and Maria will finish that one off in style. Head coach Bill Self of the U.S. looking on. Now a turnover here for Serbia. Jamari Traylor will move that one up ahead. Wayne Selden with a two-handed flush, much to the delight of the American fans. Time ticks down here in the first half. A miss there by the U.S. Serbia launches one long. It won't fall. But behind the play, we'll get a look at it here momentarily. And there you see Landon Lucas knocking down Milovanovic of Serbia. He'll pick up a technical foul. Score at the half, 26-24 in favor of the U.S. Now into the third quarter. Good ball movement here by the U.S. And they will find Frank Mason, and that one off the side rim, and it will fall. U.S. up by two. Now Stefan Pott for Serbia. Nice little pull-up runner there. And Serbia up by a deuce. Again, good ball movement here by the U.S. They'll work it around and find Vic wide open in the corner, and he makes no mistake knocking down that three-pointer. There you see the Serbian supporters looking on. Now Stefan Pott up top again. Nice little hesitation dribble right to the rack. Layup falls and he'll get fouled. Coming right at you here. Nice take there by number four, Stefan Pott. Serbia up four. 7 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. And they'll find an open Kudlesic, and he'll drain the three. Serbia now up by seven. U.S. reduces the lead to three. And they will ultimately find Selden open here for the jump shot to bring the U.S. within one. But Serbia now starting to knock down some shots from the outside. Pasakovic, he'll knock down the triple. Serbia now up three, under a minute to go. But Wayne Selden answers that one back from well beyond the arc. We're knotted up here at 65. There's a miss there by Serbia. U.S. back the other way. And Serbia will foul here with 13 seconds to go. We're tied still at 65. Wayne Selden missed the first, knocked down the second. Serbia calls timeout. And here an open Kuclesic. That one's missed. A fadeaway opportunity there, and Wayne Selden, for some reason, decides he's a volleyball player, and there's still time left. Serbia with another chance. Pasakovic, though, off the back rim, and the United States will escape with a 1-point 66-65 win here over Serbia. There's the Gwangju International Archery Center. This is the men's recurve team gold medal match featuring Korea and Chinese Taipei. There you see Korea. Lee Sung-yoon, Kubon Chan, and Kim Woo-jin. And there's the Chinese Taipei team of Wei Chun-heng, Yu Guan-lin, and Wang Hu-che. This is the third set. Korea already up 4-0, having earned 2 points for each of their set wins in the first and second. So Chinese Taipei needs to win this set to prolong it to a fourth. The Korean team, as mentioned, featuring Kim Woo-jin, who won a silver at Universiade in 2011 in the individual recurve, and was also a world champion in the team and individual back in 2011. Lee Sung-yoon of Korea is also currently ranked second in the world and set a Universiade record in the individual competition in the ranking round. Kubon Chan is ranked ninth currently in the world. Chinese Taipei has scored 57 here in the third set. So if Korea can match or beat it, as they do, that will end it, giving Korea a gold medal. 5-1. Chinese Taipei wins silver, while Russia will win the bronze. Now the women's gold medal match, also featuring Korea and Chinese Taipei. They're the Korean team of Ki Bo-bae, Kang Che-young, and Choi Mi-soon. And there's Chinese Taipei, Tanya Ting, Tsung Mei-chien, and Lin Shi-chia. We're looking now at the fourth set. Ki Bo-bae of Korea won gold in the team and individual competition at Universiade in Shenzhen in 2011 and did the same at the Olympics in London in 2012. She and Choi are both from Gwangju. This team set a new Universiade and world record in the ranking round back on July 4th. And Ki also set a world record in the individual ranking round earlier here at Universiade. Chinese Taipei up 4-2 after the third set. So Korea needs to win this one to move it into a tiebreak. 56 scored by Korea here in the fourth. And with that last arrow, Chinese Taipei will tie things in the fourth set, and that'll be enough to give them a victory, 5-3 over Korea to win the gold medal. Korea takes silver. And there you see Chinese Taipei at the top of the podium. Korea, as mentioned, silver, and Russia will win the bronze medal here in the women's recurve. Shooting action from the Nanju Jeollanam-do shooting range. There you see the start list for the men's 50-meter rifle prone team competition. There you see the athletes getting ready. And a look at the range itself. And there you see competitor 1540. That's Porapan Wariyutakarn of Thailand. And competitor 1292, that's Lee Won-gyu of Korea. The Koreans would go on to score 1,855.9, good enough for a bronze medal. The Polish team of Bartosz Jadicki, Maciej Wotasiak, and Paweł Petruk, they would take a silver medal. Well, the French team would set a new Universiade record of 1,862.3 to win a gold medal. There you see the start list for the men's 50-meter rifle prone. This competition features Yang Horan, who is the current world champion in the 10-meter air rifle. And also from Korea, Kim Hyun-jun, who set a Universiade record earlier in qualifying and won a bronze medal in this event back in 2013 in Kazan. Also competitor 1433, that's Russian Kirill Grigorian. There you see Yang. And Grigorian was fourth with his Russian teammates in the 50-meter competition earlier on. And there you see Grigorian on the left. And he's happy with that one. And there's Bartosz Jacicki of Poland. Grigorian, the gold medalist. Jacicki of Poland will take silver, while Yang Haran will take the bronze. Now the start list for the women's 10-meter air pistol final. There you see the competitors. Numerous medals being handed out today in shooting, both men and women, individual and team competitions as well. And there you get a good close-up look, Han Ji-young. Being cheered on by the supporters here. And as she wraps up, we'll get a look here at the two finalists. There is Han. And Han Ji-young, happy, a gold medalist. Here, some tears in her eyes as she will win gold on home soil here in Gwangju.